joining us now in Morehead City, North Carolina. Leland Vittert, who's been having a hard time standing up straight there. The winds have picked up considerably.
Exactly, Sean, to the point now where we're starting to hang on to things as we're out here. At some point, we're going to have to move back up to the balcony for shelter. But since we last talked, you can start to see this dock continuing to rise and rise with this rising tide. To Steve's point about people heeding the warnings, one of the things that the police and fire department had said over and over again is that once it gets bad, they're not coming to get you if you're in trouble. And it is getting to that point where the police and fire department say they just can't come help people. So people who thought, hey, I can ride this one out, as they saw it go down from a Category 4 to a Category 2, and now maybe having second thoughts, really don't have any other options than to hunker down. And there were a number of people that Steve met and that I met, of course, who were making those decisions out here. And now they're having the shingles rip off their roofs. They are obviously having a lot of other damage to their homes. And we're just in the very beginnings of this. You know, it'd be one thing to watch this on television and realize that your house was going through this for a couple of hours. Now to realize it's going through for a couple of days, or a day at least, of Florence sitting here and just spinning with these hurricane force winds. The other part of this is that it's at least two tide cycles that you will go through. So oftentimes, if you're lucky in these storms, the storm surge hits at low tide. You don't get that luck here. And because of the way the barrier islands of North Carolina are set up, they normally act as a shield, if you will, or protector from these storms as they come in. Instead, they're acting essentially as a funnel and funneling all the storm surge not only up here to something like Morehead, but farther up the rivers and up into communities that don't normally see either this kind of rain or this kind of flooding, which will have catastrophic effects. They talk about complete inundation, and that's where we're going to have rescues going on potentially now for days once the storm ends, Sean.
All right, Leland, he'll be up also hours on end with coverage, especially because the storm is going to literally slow down, lock down there for a considerable period of time. Leland, be safe.